In this video tutorial, I'm going to share with you my top PDF editor, or what I call the best PDF editor that I've used. I call it the best because it has a range of features that I like, and it's very free of charge, and you can use it, edit your document. It has more features than the top five that I did. Okay, I highlighted the top five that I've used. But after using those five, I tried to use this one, this particular one, and I found it to be exceptionally loaded with features that I never expected I could see in this one, and I have not found them in the other ones. So this PDF editor is called LibreOffice. It's under LibreOffice Suite. As we all know, LibreOffice is an alternative to Microsoft Office. You can use it to edit your document, to create documents in Microsoft Word, PDF, PowerPoint, or thereabouts. So to get to LibreOffice, all you need is just to open your browser, just type Google. You can come to the search bar over here and just search for LibreOffice. It is the first one over here, LibreOffice. You just click to start it. Alright, so you'll be brought into this very platform. You can see out now Libre 7.5, which is the latest version. So you can check out the features, what you can use LibreOffice for. But then to download it, all you need is just to come to the download button drop down over here. You can see LibreOffice download. You can just go ahead and download it. It's completely free of charge, and install it. Follow the process. It's just a step-by-step process you can follow to install. Very easy. And once you finish the installation, you can come to the launchpad and just search for LibreOffice, and you can see it over here. So you can just go ahead and open. Like you can see, you have the option to use the LibreOffice Writer, which is just like the Microsoft Word, or you have the sheet feature of the LibreOffice, which is calculate spreadsheet, or you have the Impress presentation, where you have your presentation just like in PowerPoint, and you have the drawings, where you can do all sort of drawings over there. Later, I'll make a complete video on how to use some of these features within LibreOffice. And then we have Base Database, where you can create and use database and make math formula. You can do all sort of equations writings from the LibreOffice platform. At this moment, I want to use the draw drawing feature. So you can just select on the draw drawing, and it will bring you to this very platform. Now, to import your PDF document, all you need is just to come to the open file over here, navigate to wherever you have it, and you can just click on open, and it's going to open your PDF document just like so. You can see it's been opened. And where I say I prefer it to the other PDF editors that I've used, like I said again, it's because of the tremendous features, loaded features that I've found. So if you want to go ahead and start editing your text, you can just go ahead, select anywhere within the document, and just highlight and start writing anything. Just with just that click, you can start writing things. Just select, and you can go ahead and start writing things. You can highlight things, and you can have access to the different characters, text editing features like the font styling. You can change the font style very quickly. You can have the font sizes over here to change it to any size of your choice. And you can have the option to bold, to italize, to underline things, to strike through, and to change the coloration of any choice. And you can see it has multiple different kind of color types that you can choose from. You can choose from the standard, or you can choose from the hue type, a HTML type. You can select any of your choice, and you can go ahead and play around with all of these features. Down here, you have the lists options. You can check and make create lists. If you were interested, you can have different kind of lists, and you can have different kind of paragraph alignment. You can align left, right, and center. Once you select the text, you can change the alignment, change the spacing also over here. Now you have the option to select the images, and you have these much options of the image feature that you can edit. For example, you come to the edge and you can resize it just like so. We just did dragging. You can resize, and you can play around with the color of the width, and you can check out the different styling as regards this image. The properties include all this, and you can play around with the position. You can flip it to any axis. You can flip it right, left, and you can rearrange it according to the position, or you can align it to any location, left, right, and center. And you have the option to play around with all of these features. So after you're done with the first page, you can see you can have access to the other pages as you so wish. And if you want to add other images or other features, you can come to the right over here. You can see you can add different kind of drawing tools. Maybe you can add different shapes, connecting tools, is a line or arrow tools, or connecting shapes, connecting tools, maybe between flowcharts if you want to do flowchart, or you want to just add different kind of sizing or shapes of different size on your own. You can just select it and you can come and draw them anywhere, and you have the option to play around with these features of your drawing directly. So it's very, very fantastic. You can play around with the color also of the shape, you can see of the outline. Okay, this is a line. You can play around with the thickness of the line, or you can make a broken line, and you can do so many things from here. So it's just up to you. Once you're done, you can go ahead and have access to all of these features. Also, if you want to add different kind of things, you want to print, you want to cut, you want to copy and paste somewhere, you can do all that from here. Now, once you're done editing your PDF document or all the pages and you want to save, you can just go ahead and come to the top over here. You can see save as, okay? You can see save as, or you can export as PDF, and it's going to export for you directly. So you specify, usually I keep everything at default. The format is also PDF, and just go ahead and click on export, and okay, specify location over here and click on this, select a location. Assuming I want to do here, and then you can select, give it a name, and just go ahead and say save. These loaded features are completely free of charge. Ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit about how to use LibreOffice to edit your PDF document. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye.